Well, welcome to today's episode of Scouting for History. I'm back here at this huge property. This was a farm going back to the 1700s. I've found all kinds of cool stuff here. It's enormous. I find stuff every time I come here. The guy is very nice. He lets me stop by whenever I want to. But today I'm on a mission. I'm looking for the most controversial coin ever made by the US Mint. I know I'll find one. On to the next. Here we go. Got a good signal. I flipped the plug and that's what I see staring back at me. What else is in there? I guess it's just the dime. Awesome. A merc for the day. On to the next. Well, there was some iron in the hole, but I persevered. And it's an Indian. Doesn't look like, oh, no, it does look like it held up okay. Yeah, I'll clean it up. You'll see it right here. On to the next. Now, the other day I found a Type 1 Standing Liberty Quarter. And I said it was one of the most controversial coins ever made by the US Mint. And now today at this old farm, I found the most controversial coin ever made by the US Mint. And I knew I would find one. Are you ready? It's the Lincoln Cent. Now it might not seem controversial today. It's been around for over 100 years. About the most controversial thing about it right now is today they're made out of zinc and they're horrible, horrible coins. But back when these were first released, they were revolutionary. They were hugely controversial. Let me explain. So to understand just how controversial these coins were, you have to go way back to when we were a colony. When we were a colony, we didn't have money. We used money from around the world. British money, Spanish money, French money, money from the German states, and all of that money had a picture of a king or a queen or an emperor on it. So after we won our independence and we were going to have our own money, a lot of people wanted to put George Washington on the coins, and George said no. That's what those other countries do. We don't have a ruler, we have a president. No presidents on coins. So instead, Congress passed the Coin Act of 1792, which set up the mint, established it, and set the standards for coins. And Section 10 of the Coin Act says that the front of all U.S. coins shall have three things: the date, the word liberty, and some image representative of liberty. So for 60 years, there was a picture of liberty, cap bust, drape bust, braided hair, all kinds of liberty on the front of the coins. Teddy Roosevelt, when he became president in 1901, he didn't like the U.S. coins. He didn't think they were artistic enough. He didn't like the designs of them. They were stuffy and old-fashioned. He wanted something more modern, more artsy. So he hired a famous engraver, Augustus Saint Gaudens, to design some coins. So Gaudens designed the eagle and the double eagle, and they're widely considered as some of the most beautiful coins ever made by the U.S. Mint. Unfortunately, Gaudens died before Teddy Roosevelt could have him design a coin to honor Lincoln for his 100th birthday in 1909. So it was controversial to put a president on a coin because of tradition, because of Washington not wanting presidents on coins, and because, well, it's supposed to be liberty. The second reason it was controversial was, well, the Civil War had only been 40 years earlier. So there were a lot of Southern politicians who were not thrilled with the idea of putting Lincoln on a coin. Reason number three why it was controversial, well,
Roosevelt, a Republican, was wanting to put Lincoln, another Republican, on the coins, and the Democrats didn't like that. So now, coin rules are that once the mint starts making a coin, it has to use that die for 25 years. If it wants to change a design, it has to be approved by Congress. Now, because of the tradition, because of the Southern representatives not wanting Lincoln on a coin, Roosevelt knew he wasn't going to get it through Congress. So the only coin he had left to tinker with was the penny. The Indian head cent had been around since 1859, so it was ready to be changed, and the president could make that change anytime he wanted to. So even though Roosevelt wanted a half dollar for Lincoln, he got a penny. That's why Lincoln's on a penny and not on any others. Now, Lincoln was a trendsetter. Once he appeared on the coin, then 1932, Washington followed, 1938, Jefferson on the nickel, 1946, Roosevelt on the dime, and then in 1948, Franklin on a half dollar. And that was the end of liberty on the coins. And after that, liberty was gone from U.S. coins. It's sad to say we keep putting people on the coins and not liberty. Even though, if you look, the word liberty is still on the face of every U.S. coin, along with the date. In the end, the coin was designed by Victor David Brenner, since Saint Gaudens had died. And the controversy didn't end after the coin was made. Victor David Brenner had put his initials, VDB, on the back of the coin in a prominent location. They're really small, but it's still right there for everybody to see. So people weren't happy that they were in such a prominent location. It was a new concept, putting your initials on a coin. It had only been done a few times before. Now, the mint removed the initials partway through 1909, so there's two varieties, the 1909 VDB and the 1909, and then by mint mark as well. So that controversy died down, but the coin was so popular with the public that the mint and banks had to put limits on how many you could get. The Philadelphia Mint had such long lines at one point, they limited people to 2 coins a day just to try to make sure there was enough for everyone and that the demand was met. So there you have it, just a little bit of history behind the most controversial coin in U.S. history. Stay tuned, here we go. I'm not sure what it was. It looks like it's silver. Boy, it cleaned up real nice. It was kind of deep. Maybe it was an earring of some kind. I'll look at it closer when I get home. See if I can't figure it out. On to the next. Well, I dug this up. I thought it was just trash, but I gave it a wipe. It looks like it's hollowware silver. This is very, very thin metal. They bend it and they can stamp a design into it. And then they use it for handles for things like brushes or mirrors or even cutlery. But I'll clean up, see if I can't figure out what this went to. On to the next. Well, I don't know what it is, but it appears to be silver. And the legend picked that tiny thing up at about 4 inches deep. Rang clear as a bell. Rang like a penny. You know, 41, 42. I'll see if I can't figure out what it is. On to the next. I find lots of suspender clips, but I think this one might be silver. That's cool. I'll clean it up. You'll see it right here. On to the next. Now a nice Tomback style button. I'll clean up, see if there's a design on it. Sometimes there is, sometimes there isn't. On to the next.
And now way down deep around some tree roots, the musket ball. Outstanding. On to the next. Well, and now an old cartridge spill. Lots and lots. Oh, that one's still got the bullet in it, it looks like. It's been fired. I'll clean it up. See how old they are. On to the next. Well, that's going to do it for today's adventure. Not too bad. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you learned something. Next time you dig up a penny, treat it with some respect. Well, that's it. On to the next one. Don't forget, hit like and subscribe. Come along on the next one. See you then.